Christian. Here's my testimony of the adventure that the Lord has taken me on these past 4 years, written as a letter to him. Dear Father, thank you for bringing me to Penn, my dream school. Freshman year, you know better than anyone how idealistic I was, full of hope and excitement for what lay ahead. But Lord, only you know the ways that you would break my heart and tear down my idols, the ways that you would devastate and humble me in order that I might cling on to the gospel. Freshman year, you walked with me through feelings of inadequacy. You were there when I failed my first midterm and subsequent midterms. When I saw my grades drop lower than all my friends, when I hated the way I looked so much that I couldn't even look at myself in the mirror. Having suffered from an eating disorder in high school, the battle with weight and body image continues to follow me into college. Father, only you know how much I hated myself as my uncontrollable eating habits led me to gain over 20 pounds since coming to college. But through older sisters at GCC, you showed me how much you loved me, no matter how often I tried and failed to return to the way things were before. And you still loved me, no matter how I felt about myself. And Lord, you are still sovereign, even when my dad lost his job my freshman year, when the burden of tuition left me feeling an overwhelming sense of shame for my insufficient grades and unworthiness to be here. Sophomore year, Lord, you continued to beckon to me to come to you, but the entire year was marked by busyness and confusion. I was always running around, unable to take a breath during the day. I was surrounded by a constant fear of failure and deep insecurities about not being smart enough, pretty enough, cool enough, funny enough. When I started dating sophomore year, Lord, I hurt and betrayed some of my closest friends in the deepest ways. I'm so sorry. I still feel the weight of the pain I've caused those around me. But God, in your mercy, you surrounded me with sisters, undeserved best friends who love me so unconditionally. Junior year, you forced me to come face to face with a battle with sexual sin that I had been bearing for months, and spring semester was marked by a breakup that left me shattered and broken. Thank you, Lord, for bringing me out of those dark days when it felt like I would be stuck in a state of grieving and sadness forever. Thank you for healing, for the healing and freedom that has begun in this area of sin in my life through scripture, prayer, and this loving community. Thank you, Lord, for the grace to try again. I'm still learning. And even this year, senior year, when I thought I could perfectly plan out everything in my life, you orchestrated so many events that were out of my control, causing me to surrender my plans to you. Feeling like a complete failure as a family group leader and realizing that I couldn't save even my closest friends, I found my mental health deteriorate during my fall semester in ways I couldn't control, leading me to seek counseling. Left me completely immobile on some days and brought me to a place of utter dependence on you. Mornings were spent wondering, Lord, when will you lift with despair and hopelessness? And yet, there were early mornings of running, quiet times with you, where I'd cry and run and cry out to you. Those mornings with you have been the sweetest times. And now here we are, senior spring semester. Even this semester, Lord, I lost sight of you, blinded by comparison in grades, jobs, even in serving. But you showed me yet again that you will never, ever give up on me. I know, Lord, that you're enough and you're sufficient for all my needs. We've been through a lot together, and this letter is still a work in progress. But thank you, Father. Thank you for knowing me completely and yet loving me. Thank you for loving someone as broken as me, for calling me your precious beloved daughter.